You're back. Looks like you got the intel.
Yes and no. It's a lot more complicated than that. Three six-armed giants reside in the city in the lake. Two guard the statue, one the treasure. What do you make of it?
Riddles, how quaint. Let me think. The city in the lake is clearly Mondstadt. As for the six-armed giants, Hey, that's smart. A windmill has six blades. It fits.
Wow, that makes sense!
So out of the three windmills, two are close to the statue. The other one is guarding. Let's hope it's really that simple.
Come on! Let's go take a look around that windmill! She doesn't love him at all. The passion rushing through the clear spring is just a front. When she's cold and alone, her true heart is revealed. There's another map! More riddles? Paimon's dizzy already! Oh no! Paimon used up all her brain juice! Paimon will let you have all the fun! Or you could get Kaya to help!
She doesn't love him at all. The passion rushing through the clear spring is just a front. When she's cold and alone, her true heart is revealed.
Any idea what that means?
Is this some page stripped from a love novel that you just happened to find?
Oh, so it's not a clue. No wonder someone as clever as Paimon wasn't able to get it.
I'm just joking.
Kaya.
This riddle is hard to figure out. Clear spring. Is it referring to Springvale? Passion rushing through the clear spring. So when does passion rush through a clear spring? Not a bad idea. Like when there's a waterfall, for example. It appears the solution to this enigma relates to the waterfall behind Springvale. Only the clear spring that blesses Mondstadt can reveal the passion described here. And the heart of the waterfall must refer to the cliff on the left side of the waterfall. I noticed it once when I was out on patrol in the area. The ending, cold and alone, probably has something to do with cryo, which can be controlled by a vision. You should probably take someone who can manipulate cryo with you. It's nothing. If a Knight of Favonius couldn't even answer a riddle, how could we be trusted to solve criminal mysteries?
Let's go take a look in Springvale. We'll leave you to your criminal mysteries. No, wait. Leave you to solving your criminal mysteries.
Hello. May the Animo Archon protect you.
Please be quiet within the premises and refrain.
blade. Of the Seven seems to be affected by a monster nearby. Defeating that monster might remove this strange wind current seal thingy around the Statue of the Seven.
Dodge this! Ha! Oh, so sorry.
It looks like it was drawn by a pirate. So, now... believes that there is no need. Let's go for it. Don't want anyone else to get there before we do. Like the treasure hoarders Gaia told us about. Anyways, Paimon just wants to borrow the sword to... No, you heard nothing. Paimon just wants to see it. Definitely not to become super mega powerful and do nothing but play. Chit-chat for later. Arcadian treasure hunt, here we go!
Dodge this!
must be the Arcadian ruins. Is it just me, or does it look plain? Oh, Paimon gets it! The perfect disguise is always in plain sight! Kaya's grandpa sure is impressive. It's no time to get suspicious. We're close. Hurry, the treasure is waiting for us.
Just what will we come across this time?
Frozen in time.
Come a little closer.
You.
Cool it. Dodge this. Don't push your luck. Cool it.
I'll save you the trouble. How about you let me take over? Sharp eye, but too slow. I'm Izzard. I thank you both on behalf of the treasure hoarders.
We've been keeping a low profile. How did word get out? Paimon won't let you have the treasure without a fight.
You would be wise not to underestimate us. My gang is just outside waiting for my order. However, they're not as sociable as me.
I'm sorry to rain on your parade. But your gang won't be participating in your current plan. If you'd like to ask why, you can go see them in Mondstadt Prison. Or perhaps you'd prefer to join them permanently.
The Knights. Almost had it.
Oh, you mean the treasure? Sorry, but there wasn't any treasure to begin with. You came all the way for nothing. Just give it up.
What? No treasure? Did Kaya just say there isn't any treasure?
You got me good. Didn't think the Knights would resort to such tactics.
A thief has no right to criticize the methods of the Knights of Wait, what are you-
You're not gonna get me! Okay, oh god, what is this? I didn't mean it.
What a troublemaker.
You, Knight, you're not gonna watch me die, are ya?
What an interesting suggestion.
Fine, I'll confess and go quietly. Please, just help me.
All right, then. Guess I will have to do some overtime work after all.
Don't get frostbite.
No one escapes my sight.
Try not to enjoy this too much. Don't be such a brute. You're in for a little shock. Come a little closer.
Embarrassing, having my life saved by a knight.
Don't forget what you promised, or that thing will be the least of your worries.
Hey, is this how the Knights of Favonius treats the people they catch?
I'm just joking. All right, let's take him back.
Sir! Yes, sir! Captain, should we take these two in as well?
What?
Of course not. They are the ones who made this arrest possible. Without them spreading our fabricated intel, we wouldn't have been able to catch the treasure hoarders. Stop it already. Though the treasure doesn't exist, you did want it for yourself, didn't you? Otherwise, you would have informed me of your intentions, no?
Let's talking to him.
Just a sec.
You did help me out, so you do deserve a reward. This is the triumphant harbinger of dawn that points towards victory. As its name suggests, it symbolizes light and victory. If you don't mind, I would like to present you with this harbinger of dawn as a reward.
Harbinger of Dawn?
That's right. It suits a well-cultured and disciplined person such as yourself. Wouldn't you say, Paimon?
Well, if the reward is this Harbinger of Dawn...
You'd forgive me, right? I'm honored to have such an understanding friend.
Yes, yes.
You have my apologies for the deception. I will not use the same method twice. What a wonderful day. Now, I have to go interrogate my suspect. Please excuse me. Do come visit me at our headquarters when you have the chance.
Thank you.
Wind go with you. Have you heard? The storm terror crisis.
Did something terrible happen again?
Traveler, I've been looking for you everywhere. How's that wind glider I gave you last time? Seems like it's really growing on you. But then again, you don't have a gliding license, do you?
A gliding license? What's that?
Isn't it obvious? You gotta have a gliding license to legally glide in Mondstadt.
Oh, but we've been gliding for ages now. This is the first we've heard about it.
Yeah, you've been gliding all over the place. Everyone's noticed.
So, you came looking for us because you want to give us a gliding license?
No way! The Knights of Favonius have strict rules. You need to pass an exam, and only then will the Knights issue your license. Today, I'm here as an examiner to oversee your official gliding exam. I gave you your wing glider, so this is my responsibility. At least that's what Acting Grandmaster Jean would say.
An exam? What a pain in the butt! Then again, since Amber is the examiner...
I'm sure you'll glide through it. I mean, the whole city saw how well you flew the day that Storm Terror attacked, so I'm sure you'll have no problems. But we do need to respect the rules and glide properly. Here, take this gliding manual. No need to memorize it. Just be familiar with everything in there. For example, only one person per wing glider. No carrying anything over the set weight limit. No taking off using an animo slime, and so on and so forth. Anyway, be sure to read it, okay? I had to read a load of big, thick books, too, when Lisa was teaching me magic.
Wow, that's a big old book! Paimon thinks we best get started.
Great, come find me when you're done. I'll be at Windrise.
The Knights of Favonius Gliding Manual does not sound like a fun read.
When the first wisp of wind brushed across the land, birds that yearned for the sky had wings, but no way to fly. They ask the animal god, "How can we reach the heavens?" To which the animal god replied, "You have yet to find that which is most important." As the god spoke, the wind thrust the seeds of a dandelion high into the sky. The birds thrust out their wings, but the breeze was all too mild, leaving them to stumble across the earth. So they went to the gorge, where the wind showed off its wild and incomparable strength. They threw themselves off the cliff and flapped their wings amongst the howling winds until they were able to fly freely in the sky. To the animal god they went to gleefully say, "We understand now. All we needed was a stronger wind to fly." In reply, the animal god said, "What you lacked was not wind, but courage. It is courage that has allowed you to become the first flying birds of this world."
That's a cool story. But is the Knight's Gliding Manual really written in that style? Anyway, let's go find Amber.
I can't write a piece based on this info.
urine for a little shot.
Frozen in time. Freeze.
Wait a sec.
Let it rain.
you're here. Did you have a good read-through of the gliding manual? Got all the rules down? Sounds like it was a real drag. I would know. I've been there. Ugh, the gliding manual is super dry. I couldn't get into it at all. Don't tell Jean, though.
Really? Paimon thought there were some pretty cool stories in the gliding manual.
Cool stories? Oh, you must mean the example cases in the appendix. Some of them I like. My favorite one is about the illegal animo slime takeoff. Apparently, if you pop an animo slime and take off in the burst of wind, it shoots you up really, really high. I really want to try it.
No, not that story. Paimon meant the one with the little bird who wanted to learn to fly.
What? Let me take a look. Oh, shoot. This is the storybook I used to read as a kid. Oops, sorry. I put both books in the same pile and must have grabbed the wrong one when I was leaving.
How in the heck do you confuse a bedtime story with an instruction manual?
This is so embarrassing. It's because, maybe deep down inside, that fairy tale is the thing that truly taught me how to glide. What you lacked was not wind. It's courage that's allowed you to become the first flying birds of this world. Reading that gave me the courage to glide, to become an outrider, and to become the gliding champion of Mondstadt. But anyway, let's get back to the exam. Don't be nervous. Just glide like you're used to. Okay, then. You just need to follow the marked route to the finish. You nailed it! But it's no surprise, given the way you handle your glider in a storm. The next part of the exam is in Mondstadt. See you there! Don't keep me waiting!
Alrighty then, you heard her! Back to the city! Let's not keep her waiting!
Over here! I'm all set up. Let's carry on with the exam. Same deal as before. Glide through the markers and get to the finish without stopping in the middle. You've got the hang of wind gliding now. Let's do the final stage.
Easy! You've flown this way before anyway.
Once you've passed this final stage, you'll finally be able to get your very own gliding license. Just keep thinking about that license. Ready?
Windborne Traveler, you are required to land at once by the order of the Knights of Favonius.
I am Otto of the Knights of Favonius.
What's going on?
Please, show me your gliding license. It is against the law to glide without a license. I am arresting you under Section 7, Article 12 of the Mondstadt Penal Code. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will forever carry on the wind.
Wait, I'm an instructor. This is a gliding exam.
Oh, I see. Well, you picked a bad time to hold your gliding exam.
Really? Why?
The Knights of Favonius received a report from a sister at the cathedral, claiming she saw Raptor gliding around these parts. I thought your student here must have been his partner in crime.
Raptor? Who's that?
A known criminal in Mondstadt. He always uses a wind glider to commit his crimes, so people started calling him Raptor.
flies fast then.
So far, we haven't managed to catch him. Our plan this time was to draw him into the cathedral with a precious artifact and ambush him inside. But he escaped with the artifact. Fortunately, one of the sisters put some secret markings on the artifact using elemental magic. But he was too fast, and we couldn't even keep up with the trail the markings left behind.
Well, if you need help chasing down a gliding criminal, I'm the one for the job. So tell me, which way did he go?
As far as I know, he was last seen near Springvale. But that was some time ago.
Leave it to me. With us chasing him down together, he doesn't stand a chance. Once we've got this raptor guy, we'll pick up where we left off. But no need to worry. I'll be sure to have a word with Gene.